These are my thoughts on the iPhone X after the hype. Now if you want to know more, stay tuned and let's get started. Now, the iPhone X. The iPhone X is a smartphone that, you know, is the flagship of Apple. Now, it's the first flagship that they're going to be having an OLED display on. But after watching a lot of videos, you know, the spec sheets and people talking about the specifications of the smartphone, like, I'm in two minds now. Like, I don't know whether I like it or I hate it. Like, I'm in that position where, you know, I'm now waiting for people to get their hands on experiences and, you know, get to try all these specifications out to see how well it does, you know, with the other smartphones. But at the moment, it's not looking good for me liking the smartphone. I mean, I don't want to be an Apple fanboy. I don't own any Apple products, so I'm not talking as a person that has an Apple product and I'm an Apple fanboy. I'm talking as a person that is looking from the outside, looking in. At the moment, I do not like what I see. You know, the display is not as bright as Samsung's displays. You know, the pixels are not as much as Samsung's OLED pixels. So, you know, Samsung has a 1440 display, whereas the Apple display is 1125. Let's put the specification somewhere here. So I'm really disappointed with that, and I only just found out that, you know, it has 3 gigs of RAM, 6 cores versus an 8-core Samsung Galaxy phone. Like, I'm really disappointed in Apple. You know, this is supposed to be their flagship 10th anniversary smartphone. They should have, you know, pulled out all the stops with the smartphone. I think one of the reasons why they didn't pull all the stops with the smartphone is because of the iPhone 8 and the iPhone 8 Plus. They're doing 3 smartphones in 1 year and releasing them at the same time is, you know, I'm just disappointed though. I don't know, maybe, you know, the next generation is going to be better. But for me, at this point in time, I just want to see, you know, the full hands-on videos from, you know, the other YouTubers that, you know, are out there, are gonna get their hands on these smartphones when they released, you know, in the near future, which is not so long from now. But at the moment, I feel like, you know, Apple, you know, you kind of sold us something here. You know, I don't wanna be pointing any names, but I'm really disappointed in terms of what, you know, it's the 10th anniversary of the you know, the iPhone, and I'm really disappointed in this smartphone. Maybe things will change. Things will change drawing closer to the actual, you know, release date. But what I've seen and what I've heard and what I've read on the spec sheets, I still feel like Apple could have done more with this smartphone, but they didn't. Because they're making 2 other smartphones that have the similar specifications, just that they don't have, you know, Face ID, which is something that, you know, people can do without, you know, and, you know, fingerprint ID is still a good solution in terms of, you know, unlocking or securing your phone. Even if you don't use fingerprint or Face ID, you can still put in your password if your fingerprint or Face ID doesn't work. So security at the moment, it's something that's, you know, not really a deal breaker, and it's not something that, you know, will go out of our way to say yes, this is the underlying best feature on the smartphone. You know, that's my thoughts. You know, the underlying best feature of a smartphone is the display, is the cameras, is the processors, how fast it is in terms of doing daily tasks. That's a defining moment of a smartphone, and if you can do that without having any problems and, you know, beating the rest of the competition, that's a very good smartphone. But with this iPhone X, I'm slowly changing my mind. I'm slowly really changing my mind, and I feel like, you know, something needs to give in terms of, something needs to give. Like, I don't know. Maybe Apple's gonna change with the next flagship of the smartphone. They're gonna add more features, they're gonna bump up the display to a more higher resolution and give us more nits so that we can watch content when we're outside and not being able to put our hand over our phone just to see, you know, content. Yeah, man, this has been a quick video of me talking about the iPhone X after the hype, why I feel like, you know, I'm in 2 months about it, whether I like it or hate it. It's something that has just dawned on me and I had to do this video for you guys. Now, this has been i7tech. Thank you guys for watching. Make sure to like, subscribe and press that bell so you can stay. This is i7tech and I'll see you.